Hi, welcome back. I recently got an e-bike conversion for my old mountain bike here, and there's a fair bit involved in actually getting it to fit and everything, but one of the main things is this bike has hydraulic brakes and the kit that I got had mechanical cable pull levers, and I wanted to adapt my brakes to, or my existing brake levers, to work with the e-bike kit. So I've devised a little attachment to allow me to keep my existing brake levers. Let me show you what I've done. So this is the underneath of the brake lever, and you can see there's a little boss here and there's a pin in there. So after lots of head scratching, there's basically nowhere flat or easy to clamp onto around here. You know, there's the shifters and the brakes and everything, and I was originally thinking of something that would sort of clamp on and then register the brake moving, but it took a while to come up with this solution. I've already implemented it on the other side. So here's what I've done. This little unit here has got a Hall sensor in, which is a magnetic sensor, but doesn't have a moving parts, unlike a reed switch or something. And then this little arm here has got the magnet in it. So when you move the brake, that bit moves. So in order to get that fitted, I just made a new pin for the brake lever on the lathe, turned a section of it down to about 3.2 millimeters, so it poked through the hole that was on in the bottom there. The pin's retained by a grub screw, which is just in. Grub screw's just in there. So the 3D printer strikes again. These are little housings that I've made to house the Hall sensor. These are the Hall sensors here, and these little arms are for the magnets. See, the magnet presses in there, that presses onto the shaft that gets machined, and then this just super glues around the boss on the bottom of the brake lever. So let's make a shaft and put one of these in here. This is the original pin. It's got a little groove. That's where the grub screw locates to stop it sliding out. So we're just going to put that feature in. And to be honest, it's not that critical. So I'm just going to line it up by eye. Good enough. And we'll use my new chamfering tool to tidy up the edges. The pin now needs a face and a chamfer. Let's see if I can face with this tool. Right, just going to remove the grub screw from in there. The pin just then pushes out like that. That's the old pin. Here's the new one. Yep. Grub screw back in. That's the sensor in the housing. Just need to get that wire pushed down. I'm going to super glue that in.
So that'll settle a bit. Put the sensor well in. Just smash them off.
Magnet is just a press fit in the plastic housing.
These are the brake levers that came with the bike, just regular cable pull brake levers. They've got a switch buried in there, which, you know, works fine, but there was no way I could do that on my brake levers, hence my approach. So what I'm going to do is steal this connector and cable off the brake lever. Now, as you can see, these connections, so we've got three wires here, three connections there, and I was very pleased to find that inside these cables there's three wires. So we've got ground, 5 volts and signal. Just a case of wiring this onto there, and then we just need to mount it up and plug it in, and away we go. To protect the cable, I'm going to put a bit of heat shrink on and hopefully try and get that trapped by the super glue when I glue this onto the brake cable, so that it's at least got some sort of strain relief. So I'm deliberately leaving the cables long at the moment because I haven't quite bottomed out how I'm going to wire this up long term. The cabling system has this sort of Medusa head thing, which is quite untidy. I want to build it all into this bit so that I can easily and quickly detach stuff, take it in. These things, although they're nice and waterproof, they are quite stiff, quite difficult to detach, so that's something I'm going to think about. The battery system that I'm using is two Makita 18 volt batteries to give me my 36 volts, and yes, that is a 3D printed enclosure. I'm just going to wrap this one in tape because until I've figured out my proper mounting and wiring system, this is sort of temporary, so this will do. It'll be within the bar bag, so it's reasonably protected from the elements. Is that attached? Alright, more super glue applied. This is going to go on here. There we are, I've just got to test that, make it work now. But that's all there is to it. Once I've got it set in the right position, is just put a blob of super glue on the shaft there just to stop it turning. So to test it, I'm just powering the hall sensor with 5 volts, and then I've got an LED on the output, and then I've just adjusted the magnet so that when I squeeze the lever, the light comes on. When I let go of the lever, the light goes off.
I hope you enjoyed that one. I'm pleased that I've managed to keep my original brakes on there. And it's all working nicely. I'll perhaps do a video when I come to do the tidying up the spaghetti that's in the bar bag at the moment. But for now, that's that one done. Thanks for watching. See you next time.